Good day from Hands in the Making class. So today I'm going to be teaching you on how to make use of Binance app, and then with the current CBN ban, I'm going to be showing you a way out on how you can buy cryptocurrency in Nigeria. So without much ado, we are going to go straight into business. And first, you need to download the Binance app. I've actually put this in the description below. But in case you don't have a Binance account, please use the registration link in the description below. And if you do, just follow the tutorial. Please, if you've not yet subscribed to my channel, click on the subscription button so you can always be able to get more updates like this. So here's what we do. We click on Binance. So it basically will take you to the home page, but sorry, this is not the home page. So just give me a little. Okay, this is the home page. So I'll just talk a bit about the things you'll find on the home page. So in the home page here, you can see deposit referral, launchpad and stuff like that. And for the P2P trading, this is where you basically need to click. This place has written P2P trading. Now the Visa and debit card will basically not work. So you click on the P2P trading as it appears there. Then you can see here shows you the some coins, BNB. You can see some coins here, BNB, BTC, Ethereum BTC, and you can also actually be able to slide this. So if you want to see more and all that. Now you can click on N, so it's kind of staking, and so to give you a particular percentage at a fair period of time. Let's check it out. So if you want to save whatever things you want to do, you can actually decide to earn. The choice is all yours. This is the number of percentage. BUSD 6% estimated and up. That's the amount you receive. So there is actually more. You can view them if you want to. So let's go back. I'll basically just show you how to go around Binance. So when you look down here, you would notice. Okay, here home, here market, here's trade, here's futures, and here's wallet. So I'm going to be telling you about these five icons, what you can actually be able to use them to do. So let's see. So I've shown you how the home page looks like, how to access the P2P section if you actually want to buy and sell cryptocurrency in Nigeria, in Africa, in Ghana, Cameroon, and a whole lot. Okay, so I don't know if Cameroon is there, but the P2P section is where you find your currency depending on how you register and all that. Okay, so you can see, so let's click on the markets. Now the market section, you can see that I actually have some coins already here, currency pairs or cryptocurrency pairs. Now these are actually here because I marked them as favorites. Now you can see it says add favorites. Now if I actually add favorites, I can be able to choose a particular coin that I want to add. So I can choose maybe XRP, XRP BNB, and I can actually choose that. Then for me to add a favorite, look up here, there's a star button here. If I click on that star button up here, I would actually be able to add a favorite. So when I go back to markets again, you would actually be able to see. So these favorites, you actually be able to see the XRP BNB has been added to my favorites. Okay, so this place here, you have BNB, you have BTC, you have ALTS, Fiat, ETFs. Now, so what they simply do is they allow you. Okay, let's see if it can move. So okay, I can't slide them. So now if you click on BNB, every pair that has to do with BNB, BNB is actually Binance core cryptocurrency. Now BTC, if you click on BTC, every currency pair that has to do with BTC will appear. So you can scroll down and see of them. If you click on the ALTS, you will be able to see Ethereum, TRX, XRP. So you actually be able to see those alt coins. Now the next thing is the fiat. Fiat is coins like USD, XEM and okay, USDC basically. So every coin that actually has USDC, you'll actually be able to see them. So that's basically what it does. Now for the ETFs, you'll be able to see the ETFs are basically for trading, margin trading. So you can be able to see the ETH down, EOS up, and all those coins have to do up and down. So next thing, that's for spot trade. So if you click on futures or you click on zones, because all I showed you now was in spots. So if you click on futures, let's go futures, you can be able to still see the coin, the USDM, the coin M, and the rest. So zones, you can see all the coins for zones, Serum and the rest, innovation. So you can actually be able to see all you need to see. They're all here and all that. So so we've actually seen how the market functions. Okay, I want to show you something little again about how the market functions. So one of the things, you can actually be able to search out any coin in the market. Yes, you can actually be able to search out any coin in the market. So now you have, so up here you have search coin pairs. So whatever coin pair it is that you click on, it actually appears there. So if you choose maybe BTC Ethereum, you find it there. If you choose BTC BNB, you find it there. But please, when typing it, do not put the slash. So I'm going to give an example. Let's see. So let's see BTC BNB. Now you notice that this did not appear. It doesn't mean that there's no pair for BTC BNB. So let's see. If I write in BNB BTC, now there's actually a pair for BNB BTC. So most of the time, what you simply need to do with them, if you want to bring out a particular pair, you type in the first one, it doesn't appear, or the first, like BNB BTC appeared, and maybe you type in BTC BNB, doesn't appear, just do it an inverse, a reverse. So that's exactly how and what you need to do. So if you want to see coins that have to do with BNB, typing only BNB will bring all of them out. So you want to choose a pair, you want to see if it's good for you to step into the market and all that, you can click on that. So the next thing you would need to look at is, okay, so I've actually shown you how to search out pairs. Now when you search out a pair, so let me use BNB BTC. BNB BTC. I've actually noticed that most coins that come after a coin, those are the ones that appear. Like now, BTC is older than BNB, so definitely there are just few pairs actually after the BTC. There's very that starts with BTC. Most of them are actually fiat currencies. If you look closer, yes, most of them are actually fiat currencies. But the other pairs always starts with them before BTC. So like BNB BTC, so the ones you see are usually fiat. So you see BTC USDT, BTC BTC BUSD. Those are the ones that usually have that pair. So most of that ones will actually be maybe XRP BTC, XRP, and you know, just like that. So okay, let's move on. So let's see the next thing here. Now I've shown you how to search. So let's say I make use of BNB BTC, no slash please. So I click on it. Now you notice it showed me 10 times. That's not 10. Okay, let me talk a bit about volume. So this red tells me how many percent it has done in 24 hours. Now if you go back to the home page, you will see, I just press the cancel button, you will see here in the home page, this place shows you gainers. All these people are the top gainers. These five, you can see, they are the top gainers. They are the top gainers. But we also have the losers too. And this in green is the percentage you've actually done. That's the percentage you've actually done in 24 hours. So you can actually be able to see the losers. To see the losers, you click on it. And see, we have 25 hours volume and all that. So it tells you how much you've done in 24 hours. Okay, so
So yes, for losers. So these are the losers. These are the lowest guys. If you want to see how much you've traded in 24 hours volume, you can click here to see that. So now if you want to see all markets, you can click here for you to see that. You want to see BNB, BTC market, ALTS market, and all that. You can actually visit it by clicking there. So the next thing I want to show you, I've shown you how to go into a particular coin, and I told you BNB. Let's go back there and see.